Hi everyone. Do you love birds and want to give something back? With citizen science, you can. In this video, we'll be focusing on how you can help Australia's fairy wrens. I'll provide a step-by-step demonstration and all the details you need to get started. Best of all, the whole process is free and easy. Your contributions will be used by scientists to aid research into this beautiful group of birds. By the end of this video, you'll be able to call yourself a fairy wren citizen scientist. Let's get started. Let's start with a quick overview. First, we'll cover a bit of information about citizen science, along with the requirements and different levels of participation for this project. Next, we'll go through a step-by-step demo on how you can report your fairy wren sightings. After that, we'll put on the bird nerd glasses and discover how to tell dull males and females apart. Finally, we'll end with resources and a summary. First off, what is citizen science? It's primarily about collecting data by members of the public like you and me. Organizations and professional scientists typically define what kind of data they need and what they hope to learn from it. In the traditional research model, data collection is limited to just a few people working or volunteering to collect the required data. Citizen science offers one major advantage. It can scale far beyond the traditional model. Instead of just a few people collecting data, we can have hundreds or even thousands of citizen contributors. This is exciting because with the power of the internet, contributors can be spread across multiple points across a region, country, or even the world. This provides researchers with significantly more data and spread across a much wider area than what they could have done with a small team. There are many citizen science projects, but the one I'll be covering in this video is the Fairywren Project. This project started in 2018 and is still going strong. The primary research objective is to discover how environmental conditions affect fairy wren group sizes and plumage types. Please note that I'm a project participant, not an official part of the project team. I made this video to encourage more people to join the cause. The more eyes and ears we have out there, the better. So who can participate in this project? Anyone and any age, providing they can tell apart different species of fairy wren. For those wanting to brush up on their fairy wren identification skills, I've included a link to my previous video, Learn to ID Fairy Wrens of Australia. Another requirement is this project focuses on fairy wrens in Australia. We have 10 species of fairy wren across the country, so you're likely to be able to find some close to home. You can participate in the project regardless of whether you're a resident or you're visiting Australia. You might be thinking, what do I get out of this? Besides the enjoyment of observing some of Australia's most beautiful birds, you can also get the warm fuzzies knowing your contributions are going towards a great purpose. The data that you collect will not only contribute to the research goal of the Fairy Wren Project, but serve as a valuable resource for future projects, namely conservation. This way, fairy wrens can be enjoyed for generations to come. If all this is sounding good, how do we get started? Contributing to the project is simple. You don't even need to register with the project. However, you do need to have an eBird account. If you haven't got an eBird account, signing up is free and there are no ongoing costs. I understand that some of you may be hesitant to use eBird because you don't want to be glued to your phone during your bird watching experience. You can still contribute to this project by jotting down your observations on a notepad and then submitting them via the eBird website on a computer when convenient for you. For those comfortable using their phone, download the eBird app. It's available on Android and iPhone. If you're unfamiliar with eBird, don't worry, I'll be showing you the basics in the upcoming demo. Okay, your eBird account's all sorted. Now what? The Fairywren Project offers three levels of participation: basic, intermediate, and advanced. Each level builds on the next, so if you choose advanced, you'll be doing the activities of basic and intermediate at the same time. Let's go over the basic level first. Our focus here is on the plumage types we see. Fairy wren females stay in dull plumage throughout the year, whereas most males will cycle through bright and dull plumage depending on the breeding season. To indicate to the project which plumage types we see, we use the following letters in our observation. First, we have the easiest to spot. B for bright or breeding plumage. Next is I for intermediate. This occurs when the male is going into or out of breeding plumage. They may look patchy or a cross between bright and dull. The following four plumage types look similar. We have D for dull males. Then we have F for female, J for juveniles, which look like females with short tails, and U for unknown dull. So when we see a fairy wren, we provide the breakdown of plumage types in the comments section. We note down the number we saw, followed by the plumage type. For example, one bright male and two females would be 1B and 2F. So you don't have to commit all these codes to memory. I've included a printable download of the plumage codes in the video description. You can check it out at the end. And don't worry if you can't tell dull males and females apart yet. There's a special section on how to do just this after the demo. The next level of participation is actually more straightforward than the basic level. We're just on the lookout for any breeding behaviors, such as adults carrying nesting material, sitting on a nest, feeding their young. To record these behaviors, we click on the add breeding code within the eBird observation. I'll go through this in the demo. The final level of participation is more specialized. It involves monitoring fairy wren group interactions for 5 to 10 minutes. This level is too in-depth for this video. If you want to learn more about it, check out the Fairywren Project website. Let's jump into a demo to see how to record our observations, then submit them. Okay, we've arrived at our birdwatching location. Let's open up the eBird app. This is eBird for Android, but the interface for iPhone is practically the same. Let's start our checklist. So we click start. Go up to the top here and click this location icon. This allows us to see a limited list of which birds are available in this area. Let's first type in fairy wren to see which fairy wrens are in this area. So here we have three different types. I can hear a superb fairy wren calling, so let's go investigate. Okay, I see one bright male and a female. There's another dull fairy wren jumping around off camera, which I can't get a good visual on. So I'll give this species a count of three, and then in the comments I place 1B for bright, 1F for female, and 1U for unknown dull. By the way, with the plumage codes, it doesn't matter what order you put them in or whether it's in uppercase or lowercase. Let's see what else we can find. I see a redback fairy wren flitting around. For the people who want to participate on the intermediate level, let's imagine that this one's holding nesting material in its bill. What we need to do is we add the plumage types, then we click the add breeding code. I find this interface cumbersome because not everyone's gone to the effort of memorizing these codes. What I do is I click through each one until I find the appropriate code. For this one, we want to put CN, carrying nest material. Then if you like, you can add further details into the comments section. I like to separate this with a semicolon. Let's move on to another section. Okay, we just missed a flock of seven variegated fairy wren. You'll probably run into a situation where you can identify the species, but you don't get enough time to examine the plumage in detail. When this occurs, we put down the count of that species, and then we only write down the plumage types that we saw. So let's say here I saw seven variegated fairy wren. Two of them were bright males, three were females, but I wasn't able to see the other two, so I just omit that. When the researchers see that the plumage numbers and the species number doesn't add up, they'll assume those missing numbers are present but indeterminate. It's still a valid submission. That's all there is to it. Now you can continue your checklist and add other species if you like, but this time you don't have to go into so much detail. Once you're done, click review, fill out any details, scroll down to make sure the species counts are correct and that all your fairy wren species have the comments against them, and we click submit, and you're done. What can I submit? All sightings count, but please only submit wild birds. Captive birds provide no research value. For example, fairy wrens you see on a bird walk are good, and so are ones visiting your backyard. Birds you see at the zoo? No way. Having accurate data is critical for research. A golden rule of eBird is that you must only record a species when you're absolutely sure that they are present. This means no guessing or assuming. If you need help confirming an ID, don't hesitate to ask someone. Let's discuss how to tell whether the dull fairy wren that you see is a male or a female. A common theme amongst fairy wren species is that females have a uniform orange or beige bill. In contrast, males have an entire black or at least a tinge of black on the bill. This is true regardless of what part of the plumage cycle the male is in. The lovely and purple-crowned fairy wrens are exceptions to this rule. However, it isn't a problem because in those species, the male and female can easily be told apart by their plumage. The females and dull males of the red-backed and white-winged fairy wrens look practically the same, so mark any dulcicy of these species as U for unknown dull. I know these codes and rules might be a bit overwhelming, and you might be thinking, I can't tell the difference between a dull male, female, or juvenile. And that's perfectly fine. For situations where you don't feel comfortable calling the code for a dull, simply record these as unknown dull. Even if your skill level only allows you to identify bright males and you mark the rest as unknown, this is still valuable data that the researchers can use. Let's summarize what we've covered. The Fairywren Project offers three levels of participation: basic for plumage types, intermediate to include the breeding codes, and advanced that covers group dynamics. We saw in the demo how to insert the plumage and breeding codes into your eBird checklists, and then how to submit them. We then covered what you can submit and how you can tell apart males and females. And we're done! Be sure to check out the links and resources I've left in the video description. I highly recommend you visit the Fairywren Project's website and sign up to their newsletter. They post regular updates on how your contributions are making a difference. If you found this video helpful, give it a like or share it with a friend. The more Fairywren citizen scientists, the better. And if you're interested in other bird-related citizen science projects or you have any questions, feel free to reach out in the comments. That's it for now. Wishing you fantastic bird watching and catch you next time.